G'day YouTube, Warbles on a lot here with the third Mad Scientist movie regarding the construction of thumb nuts. We've already seen how to go from a rough sawn drilled blank to a helically pitched winged thumb nut, or as I like to think of these ones, they're thumb turbines. They have a leading edge, they have a trailing edge, a flat side underneath and a curved side on top. If given the support of even the most rudimentary bearing, they will in fact spin in the breeze. Now that's a sight you don't see every day. Yeah? A thumb turbine spinning on a pipe stem. However, as cute as a thumb turbine is, and this one has a machine manufactured joint right across the hub, there are some people who prefer straight winged thumb nuts. So for this third movie in the series, I will demonstrate how we carve a straight winged thumb nut from a sawn blank which has already been drilled and profiled. So the next job is to remove the excess wood from the blank, which we do with a fairly coarse rasp. And because the wood's so soft, you just got to be careful. Nearly wrecked it. Shift to a more gentler file. We don't want any more of those happening. Pretty good, pretty good. Shift to the voice. Use a different grasp. You get a flat level surface. Seems more better. Yes, much more better. And by the miracle of the pause button, I'll just save you the time while I do the other side. Right, there we have a profiled, sawn blank, which now needs just a few more drawings on the wood, just to give me something to aim for. And once again, that has to be on both sides, just because it's done by hand and by eye doesn't mean you can't benefit from some guidelines. And once again, helps to have the guidelines on all sides. Now just cut away everything that looks wrong and cut down to the line. Okay, wish me luck. First face. Well, we'll do top sides. Thank you. check the framing. One of the tricky bits is that the more curves you carve onto it, the less flat bits there are for the vise to grip on. And it sort of gets harder and harder. To anchor the work. So I tend to leave a square edge on the ring until I've got these wings as close as I can get them. To their final profile. And by leaving square edges on the ring here, I can grip it in the vise while I keep going with this profiling job. And the closer I get, the finer the rasps I'm using to do the work. Pretty soon I'll be coming down to this. In fact, I might try it now. It's important to get your head in the right place physically to be able to line your eyes up with the the symmetries and the asymmetries that you're trying to achieve. We have the one and we have the other as a comparison. And again, by the miracle of the pause button, I'll spare you the effort of having to watch the other side get carved. Okay, so now I'm going to try and even things up. By clamping on the ring and working from this angle. Yep, and again, the magic of the pause button is about to save you some time. And voila, it's almost ready for the final ring reaming. And after I get done with that, then it'll be on to the sandpaper. So this has to be done fairly carefully. Keep everything in round and avoid breaking the damn thing, because it's starting to get pretty delicate. This is a lady's thumb nut. So it's got to fit on my little finger. It's not too bad. Not too bad. Okay, well, I reckon that's ready for the sandpaper now. And you'd be surprised how effective a piece of torn off, broken belt from a belt sander can be on this really soft wood. As I will hope to demonstrate. So as you can see, there's just about as many steps, just as much precision, just as much wood got to be cut away to make a straight wing thumb nut as to make a bent wing thumb nut. Because the ladies' ones are 20% smaller than the men's, because men's thumbs are larger than women's, they take about 30% more time to make a man's than a woman's. But fixed and the straight and twisted wing varieties are about the same in terms of time. In terms of aesthetics, I prefer the twisted wings. That's why I developed them. First time I saw one of these, it was a picture sent to me by my daughter, and it was a straight wing variety of a thumb nut. And I immediately figured that if I was going to go to all the trouble of hand carving wooden wings on a wooden ring to fit on a thumb, and I might as well go to the extra trouble of making them helical wings. It's not particularly that much more difficult. In my opinion, warbles on a lot to YouTube. Ciao.